Welcome to EPG Pathshala. I'm Dr. Abu Saleh, an assistant professor of English at the Raja Pyare Mohan College, University of Calcutta. Today we'll be discussing a module on Thomas Kidd, and this module has been prepared by Mr. Mohiminul Islam, who is a research scholar at the University of Hyderabad. In this module, generally we'll be discussing life and career of Thomas Kidd. We'll be discussing about his literary style and further influences. So let us start with the module. This module tries to explain the life and career of Thomas Kidd as well as his contribution to the history of English literature. The content also tries to study how Kidd was interested in exploring the other kind of stories like Roman story. It also explicates how he addresses and correlates to contemporary political concerns, and in calling our attention to moments where this kind of parallelism breaks down. The study also addresses how Kidd becomes very important writer of his time. Moreover, it explains his Spanish tragedy in detail and tries to explain his translated works too. In addition, the module also concentrates and comments on other Elizabethan writers of the time, especially the university wits. Thomas Kidd was born on 6th November 1558. Though there is no record of the day in particular, but he was baptized in the church of St. Mary's, Ulnoth, in the Lombard Street of London. He was a son of Francis Kidd and Anna Kidd. Francis Kidd was a scrivener, and later he became the warden of the Scrivener's Company. At this school, Kidd was well received and his education was well rounded. Along with that, he developed physical education, music, drama, and a good character of his own. At that time, he also shown that he is pretty much interested in the study of Latin. Latter part of Elizabethan era, he was joined by the university wits. He became very important member of the group, and because of his contribution to drama, is great and both instinctively and historically important. The details of the great Renaissance playwright Thomas Kidd's life is obscure. O. Corner says that in 1580s, Kidd became an important playwright of the era. There are very rare people who know about his activity. That Hoy Francis Meres said, Kidd was among our best for tragedy. Thomas Heywood elsewhere called him famous Kidd. At the same point, Ben Jonson called him the sporting Kidd, and it is thought that by 1589 he had written a lost Hamlet, sometime referred as Your Hamlet, which was likely a model of Shakespeare tragedy. At the last moment of his life, he was involved in various political activities. That's why he was imprisoned and tortured. Finally, he was released from prison, but he had continued his life to live in poverty and died very young. After discussing his personal life, we'll now discuss about his literary achievements. So, let us see. Kidd probably started writing as a popular playwright sometime in 1583 and produced his most significant work, The Spanish Tragedy. He had written this popular Elizabethan revenge tragedy between 1582 and 1590, sometime between 1582 and 1592. Although somewhat crude both dramatically and poetically, this extremely popular play did much to determine the greatest disasters of the late Elizabethan and Jacobean period. He appears to have had more or less acquainted with French, Italian, Spanish, and Latin, and he was also translating various pamphlets and letters of that time. He translated Torquato Tasso's Padre di Famiglia, which came in 1583, published as The Householder's Philosophy in 1588, is the only non-dramatic work by Thomas Kidd. which is attributed to Thomas Kidd. Robert Garnier's Cornelia, published as the same name in 1594. Thomas Kidd also was credited with an early edition of Hamlet, as we discuss our Hamlet, but it was lost in the time. Now, after discussing literary writings of Thomas Kidd in short, we'll see and discuss little bit about the university wits. The second half of the Elizabethan era was dominated by the university wits. It was a group of people from Oxford and Cambridge universities. They are basically scholars. John Lilly, Thomas Kidd, George Pilly, Thomas Lodge, Robert Greene, Christopher Marlowe, and Thomas Nast were the members of the group. The members of the group began their career as actors and also revised some old plays. They came to London to try their luck as professional playwrights, and immediately before Shakespeare, they were quite famous. Among the members of the university wits, Thomas Kidd was a very important member. Dr. B.B. Jain notes George Sampson's statement that Kidd was a first English dramatist to discover the bearing of the episode of the dramatic movement upon the character. In other words, he was the first English playwright who writes dramatically. So, after discussing little bit of university wits, now we'll see the other works of Thomas Kidd. Thomas Kidd's works include The Householder's Philosophy, which came in 1588, The Spanish Tragedy, which came in 1592, The Tragedy of Soliman and Persuada, which came sometime between 1592 and 1593, The Murder of John Brewin, which came in 1592, Cornelia came in 1594. He also wrote part of some of works like Our Hamlet, the first part of Geronimo, King Lear, Aidan of Feversham, and Edward III. Now let us discuss major and some minor themes of Thomas Kidd's works. Thomas Kidd adopted horrors and the theme of the revenge, the trapping of ghosts and chorus, the long speeches and rhetoric of Senecan drama. He pointed the way to a new form of merging the impulses of the popular drama with the structure and methods of classical drama, such as tragedy and comedy. He was also characterized bohemian. He likes bohemian life and in the grub street of his day. Simultaneously, he uses republican political thought of his writings to tell about the loss of republican liberties, to comment on Elizabethan constitutional concerns. Now let us discuss some characteristic features of his work. His plays constantly employ dramatic irony, a situation in which one or more characters act without full knowledge of the facts, but those facts are known by the audience. The most important characteristic feature of Thomas Kidd's works are romantic elements, which are overt in his attitude and represented in the spirit of the Renaissance. The comparative religious tolerance was also one of the characteristic feature of his writing. To continue with the characteristic features of his work, it is to be said that his sense of dramatic propriety helped rescue blank verses from the monotony for use in genuine dramatic expressions. For example, the line was rapped by the Jeronimo in the Spanish tragedy that, eyes, no eyes, but fountains fraught with tears. O life, no life, but lively from death. His plays also show self-consciousness about the understanding ways that the fit between classical Rome and the Elizabethan present remains problematic. Now, after discussing themes and characteristic features of Thomas Kidd's works, we'll discuss one of his important work, that is The Spanish Tragedy. The Spanish Tragedy is subtitled as Jeronimo is Mad Again. It's an Elizabethan tragedy written between 1582 and 1592. The Spanish Tragedy established a new genre in English literature, the revenge play or the revenge tragedy. It is an enduring achievement of Keed in the regard of history of English literature. The plot of the drama contains several violent murders and includes one of its characters, a personification of revenge. This drama was often referred to the parody in the works written by other Elizabethan playwrights, including William Shakespeare, Ben Jonson, and Christopher Marlowe. Now, let's know a little bit about Spanish tragedy. So, we'll talk about summary of Spanish tragedy. The play shows how the world is being just when there is no much injustice. It is basically the question of how bad things can happen to good people. The play also shows how Keed creates love for antithesis, parallelism, and balance, and an oxymoron. Professor Murray says in his book, Thomas Keed and the Spanish Tragedy, that it tells us almost nothing about Keed, but does provide cultural context for the play, especially Senecan drama and Roman comedy, together with some analysis of the play's structure. Hieronymo is an avenging hero, and he decided to achieve justice following the vicious slaying of his son, Horacio. But he also became a memorable exponent of what would go yet another recurring feature of revenge drama, the lengthy rhetorical and expository soliloquy, which frequently lays bare his grief, despair, and sheer mental fragility for the consideration of spectators. We are discussing Spanish tragedy, and we find that in the play, the audience is being invited into the conversation and demanded at various stages to get into its own dominations about the rights and wrongs of what Hieronymo is debating with himself. And this method of speech making will be replicated throughout. Moreover, Julie Sanders says that this soliloquy is then an early foray into the exploration of friendship with the audience that other revenge heroes, and that indeed includes villains, would expand upon as the tradition advanced. Now, after discussing the Spanish tragedy, we'll discuss another work of Thomas Keed, that is The Householder's Philosophy. The Householder Philosophy is originally published in Italian. It was first written by an excellent Italian orator and poet, Signor Torquato Tosso. The original title of this drama is Padre di Famiglia, which came in 1583. In 1588, Thomas Keed translated this work and published as The Householder's Philosophy. In the 19th century, it was again translated by T.K. Huerinto. It is annexed in a diary book for all good housewives. In Householder's Philosophy, we find that it gives an opportunity for displaying of some words and ends of classical knowledge. It also perfectly and profitably describes the true economics and form of housekeeping. The drama, dedicated to all good housewives dwelling within the country of South Hampshire. Further, the translator Bartholomew Doy wishes into them all here in his life, health, wealth, and prosperity, and hereafter in the life to come joyfully and endlessly. Now, after discussing the Spanish tragedy and the Householder's Philosophy, we will discuss another work of Thomas Keed, which is supposed to be said that he has partly written, or which is somewhat mystery. Now, let us consider Keed's Our Hamlet, and let us discuss the work. It is to be said that Our Hamlet is one of the important texts of Thomas Keed as well as English drama. Though it is unclear about the authorship of the work, it is to be said that some part of the play is written by Thomas Keed. Many critics say and argue that Thomas Keed has written the play, as well as Thomas Nast ascribes Keed as the writer of the play. Further, the scholars are inclined to believe that the play exists as it is supposed to be a lost one, And William Shakespeare has used this play as a model for his famous and popular one, Hamlet. Nevertheless, it is to be said that it was first performed on the stage of England in between 1588 and 89. It is the story of Hamlet that Shakespeare used in his popular play, Hamlet. It is more or less the same of Shakespeare Hamlet. It explores the revenge theme as Thomas Kyd is good with, and possibly it is more accurate to say that Shakespeare play explores the revenge theme as just Kyd did in his play work. Now, after discussing the Spanish tragedy, the householder philosophy and our Hamlet, now we'll see another important work of Keats, that is Cornelia. Cornelia is a closet drama which was published in 1594. This play creates the debate about place of classical republicanism with the political mentality of the late Elizabethan England. The argument is concerned with the literary critics. Curtis Perry said that literary critics tend to use as evidence, since the nature of the relationship between stories of the people tell one another and their political thought can be difficult in practice to pin down. Cornelia is set during the Roman Civil Wars. It was against the backdrop of Caesar's victories and the end of the republics. It is one of the numerous early modern narratives dealing with the accession and decline of the Roman Republic. Obviously, the story of the play present to be a relevant Elizabethan one, but in it itself not necessary. It is the English writers and their audience to see their own political milieu as a republican of that time. Now, we'll discuss another important work of Thomas Kyd, that is the Tragedy of Solomon and Persuada. The drama was written by Thomas Kyd, which was published in 1592 or sometime in 1593. Kevin Cornby says the Tragedy of Solomon and Persuada is a rare performed play attributed to Thomas Kyd because it appears as Jeronimo's revenging metadrama in Act 4 of Spanish Tragedy. As blood-soaked tragedy, it is certainly worthy of so great a writer, though ultimately Kyd's authorship can never be proved. The story of this drama is about love and revenge. In this play, Persuada is a beautiful Rhodes Islander who is besotted with her young knight, Erastas. The young knight proves himself a triumph and a tournament staged by the island's governor. Having exchanged jeweled favor with his beloved, but unfortunately, the knight loses Persuada's gift, the precious necklace one. As a result, it leads to the death of Ferdinando, and the Erastas escapes from there for not to get punished. Later, Erastas proves his valor and honor and is befriended by the hot-tempered emperor. Furthermore, Solomon elects to occupy Rhodes in the preceding capturing Persuada. The reason behind such kind of a trap is Solomon falls hopelessly in love with Persuada. But later, Persuada and Erastas are reunited. That's why Solomon is forced to see the two young infidels not as a friend and consort, but embarrassing enemies. Finally, Solomon kills Erastas and unwarily fighting with the disguised Persuada. So to conclude this module, we can say that scholars find Kyd's writing the best expression of feeling, thought and vigor action in order to develop the genre of drama. Thomas Kyd is interested in exploring the Roman story. He addresses and correlates to contemporary political concern, and in calling our attention to moments where this kind of parallelism breaks down. Along with that, he becomes very important because of his membership to the group of university wits, Moreover, his Spanish tragedy shows how the world is being just when there is no much injustice. His translated works also mark on his career and literary life. In addition, the module also concentrates and comments on other writers of the time in order to critically judge the activities, especially writings of Thomas Kyd. Finally, his plays create and debate about the place of classical republicanism with the political mentality of late Elizabethan England. The argument is concerned with literary critics. Curtis Perry says, the literary critics tend to use as evidence, since the nature of the relationship between the stories people tell one another and their political thought can be difficult in practice to pin down. To summarize the module, we can say that in this module we have learned about Thomas Kyd, his personal life, about his affiliation to the University Wits, and his initial works as a member of University Wits, which has helped other future writers, especially like Shakespeare. Also, we have found that many of his works are not attributed to him, especially because it's in very old time before Shakespeare, and that's why those works were at that time mostly anonymous. But anyway, whatever the works are attributed to Thomas Kyd are quite important, and especially the Spanish tragedy, the householder's philosophy are quite important in the history of English literature. We have discussed, after discussing his personal life, we have discussed Thomas Kyd's Spanish tragedy, householder philosophy, Cornelia, and other important texts. And also we have discussed thematics and characteristics features of Thomas Kyd, and at the end we have seen how he was also involved with the political activity group and activity of Elizabethan period. He was also imprisoned for that reason. So hope you like the video, and if you want to know more about this module, especially Thomas Kyd and his works, you can read the e-text, which detailed everything, and also you can have a look at the further reading section, which also lists a book, various books and articles related to Thomas Kyd and his works. Also, you can participate in the quiz section and know about your own involvement and learning with this module. Thank you so much.